Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And we are discussing the steam power cycle, module 6. And this is third lecture on the steam power cycle. We recap from the first two lectures. In the first two lectures, we discussed the Rankine cycle. We derived the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. We discussed the mean temperature of heat addition for the Rankine cycle, and we solved a few problems on the simple Rankine cycle. And this lecture, the topic is reheat Rankine cycle, and we will explain reheat Rankine cycle, and we will solve few problems on the reheat cycle. The learning outcome for the students. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the reheat Rankine cycle, and the student will be able to solve problems on the reheat Rankine cycle. So, we discussed the basic Rankine cycle. In what way we can improve the Rankine cycle? As an engineer, we have to think how to improve the Rankine cycle for better efficiency, or how to increase the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. So, if you look at the efficiency equation, there are three parameters: turbine work, pump work, and the heat supplied in the boiler. So, if you want to increase the efficiency of the Rankine cycle, there are two possibilities. Either you have to increase the numerator or decrease the denominator. So, increasing the numerator, it means you have to increase the turbine work. So, when you increase the turbine work, work output from the turbine, we can increase the efficiency of the cycle, or we have to decrease the amount of heat supply from the external source. So, amount of heat supply in the boiler we have to minimize or reduce, then the efficiency will increase. So, these are all the two possibilities, and these two possibilities, that is what improvement in the Rankine cycle. So, increasing turbine work, it is called as reheating process. So, that is the process which is used to increase the turbine work is called as reheating process, and decreasing the amount of heat supply, it is called as regeneration process. So, in this lecture, we will be discussing about the reheating process. In the lecture to follow, we discuss the regeneration process. So, this is the reheat Rankine cycle. So, in the simple Rankine cycle, we had only one turbine, a single turbine. With multiple stages. Now, we have two stages of turbine, HP turbine and the LP turbine. So, the steam enters the HP turbine from outlet of the boiler with the state 1. It enters the HP turbine or high pressure turbine, and it is expanded, and the work is produced. So, the work after expansion, the steam goes to the boiler once again. So, here we have a device, heat exchanger, called reheater. So, through the reheater tubes, the steam is recirculated, and the heat is added to the steam, and again it is converted into superheated steam. So, the pressure is low, but it becomes superheated steam. So, with this condition, the steam expands in the low pressure turbine. So, after expanding in the low pressure turbine, the low quality steam, the outlet steam, it goes to the condenser where the heat is removed. So, the heat is removed in the condenser by circulating water, and then it is converted into condensate, that is liquid form. Then the liquid, it goes to the pump. So, using the pump, we are pressurizing the fluid, and it is circulated back to the boiler. So, the liquid water, it is heated in the boiler and converted into steam, and again the cycle is repeated. So, this is a reheating cycle, ideal reheating cycle. The corresponding enthalpy entropy diagram or temperature entropy diagram. So, this is the black color line is the saturation line. So, anything within the saturation line, anything within the saturation, it is wet steam. So, here outside the saturation line, it is superheated steam. It is unsaturated liquid here. This area is unsaturated liquid, and this is the wet steam, and this area right hand side is the superheated steam. Number 1 is in the superheated region. So, the steam enters the high pressure turbine with a superheated condition, and it is expanded. So, 2 is the outlet of the HP turbine. So, the condition here, it may be wet steam, it may be dry steam, or it may be superheated steam. It depends on the design. So here in this diagram, it is superheated steam. So 2 is also in the superheated condition, and then 2 to 3, it is further heat addition in the reheater. So the steam is further heated and the temperature is increased. So normally in the design, T1 equal to T3. So the temperature of the steam entering the high pressure turbine is equal to temperature of the steam entering the low pressure turbine. So from 3 to 4, the steam is expanded in this low pressure turbine and it becomes wet steam. At the outlet, it is wet steam. Then the heat rejected at constant temperature. So at the end of the condensation process, the fluid becomes saturated liquid. So phi is the saturated liquid, and then it is compressed to increase the pressure, isentropically compressed. So after isentropic compression in the pump, so the 6 is the state, then the heat is added in the boiler. So 1 to 2 isentropic expansion, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and 4 to 5 constant pressure heat rejection, 5 to 6 isentropic compression, and 6 to 1 it is again constant pressure heat addition in the boiler. And this is the reheat cycle. Now we have to calculate the parameter, working parameter. So there are two turbine work, H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. And there is one pump work, H6 minus H5. And there are two heat addition processes, H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. So we calculate one by one the work done and efficiency of reheat Rankine cycle. So the turbine work output WT equal to the work output of the HP turbine, high pressure turbine, plus work output of the low pressure turbine, which is H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. And the pump work input equal to WP equal to H6 minus H5, which is equal to VFI into P6 minus P5. And the heat supply in the boiler, QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. Then efficiency of the reheat Rankine cycle, eta equal to W net divided by heat supplied, which is WT minus WP divided by the heat supplied. So WT from this equation, WP from this equation, and the heat supplied from the third equation. So we substitute here and calculate the efficiency of the Rankine, reheat Rankine cycle. So the advantage of reheating. So there is an increase in the output. The main objective of reheating to increase the efficiency and output of the turbine, that is possible, that is achieved. So there is an increased output of the turbine. Erosion and corrosion problems in the steam turbine are eliminated or avoided. There is an improvement in the thermal efficiency of the turbines. Final drainage fraction of the steam is improved, and there is an increase in nozzle and diffuser, nozzle and blade efficiency. So first point, it is very clear, output of the turbine increases. Then erosion and corrosion problem of the steam turbine are eliminated. So what is erosion and corrosion of the steam turbine? So when you have a single stage turbine, single turbine, at the end of the turbine, that is later stages of the turbine, there is a the moisture content of the steam, it will be more. So for example, if you have 0.8 or 0.9, so there is 10% moisture content. So the 10% moisture content, 10% water particle, right, that will cause the erosion and the corrosion of the problem in the blade, turbine blade. Now, using the reheating process, the amount of the moisture content in the steam turbine is reduced. So the drainage fraction is increased. So the erosion corrosion problem, it may be eliminated or completely avoided. And as we expected, so there is increase in the thermal efficiency of the turbine, and final drainage, that is what I told earlier. Final drainage fraction of the steam is improved in the reheating process. So the erosion corrosion problems are eliminated. So there is an increase in nozzle efficiency and the blade efficiency. So overall efficiency and individual component efficiency, everything is improving. And there are few disadvantages of reheating process. Reheating process require more maintenance because we have additional component, additional piping system. So we require more maintenance, and the cost of the maintenance will be higher. The increase in thermal efficiency is not appreciable in comparison with the expenditure incurred in the reheating process. So we invest money on the reheating. For reheating, reheater, piping, we have to invest money. So the efficiency increase, it is not in compensation with the amount of money invested in the reheating process. That is the disadvantage. So we take a problem here. So example number 6, this is from Anna Institute question paper November 2018. a steam power plant running on Rankine cycle as a steam entering HP turbine at 20 megapascal and 500 degree Celsius and leaving the LP turbine at 90% dryness. Considering condenser pressure point 005 megapascal and reheating occurring up to the temperature 500 degree Celsius, determine pressure at which steam leaves the HP turbine, thermal efficiency and the work done. And the data given, so P1 inlet pressure is equal to 20 megapascal equal to 200 bar, so T1 equal to T3 equal to 500 degree Celsius and P4 equal to P5, that is outlet pressure of the low pressure turbine, P4 equal to P5 equal to 0.005 megapascal, which is 0.05 bar, and X4 equal to 0.9. The dryness fraction of the steam at the outlet of the LP turbine is 0.9. Now, we have to refer to the steam table. So, from the steam table, pressure equal to 200 bar, temperature equal to 500 degree Celsius for superheated steam. So, here we have to refer two tables, enthalpy of superheated steam table and entropy of superheated steam. So, there are two tables. So, from the enthalpy of the superheated steam, H1 equal to 3241.1 kilojoules per kilogram and entropy of the superheated steam, S1 equal to 6.146 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, so we are given the condition, clear condition P4, that is outlet of LP turbine, P4 equal to 0.05 bar and X4 equal to 0.9. We take the properties HF4 equal to 137.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG4 equal to 2423.8 kilojoules per kilogram, VF4 equal to 0.001005 meter cube per kilogram, SF4 equal to 0.476 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG4 equal to 7.92 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, this everything from the steam table corresponding to P4 equal to 0.05 bar. Now, we calculate the enthalpy here, enthalpy entropy at the P4. S4 equal to, it is wet steam. So, SF4 plus X4 into SFG4 equal to 0.476 plus 0.9 into 7.92 equal to 7.604. And H4 equal to HF4 plus X4 plus HFG4 equal to 137.8 plus 0.9 into 2423.8 equal to 2319.22 kilojoules per kilogram and H5 equal to HF5. So, refer to the diagram. So, this is the diagram. H5 equal to HF5, it is 137.8 kilojoules per kilogram. So, this is the Rankine cycle. Now, the pressure, actually we have calculated the properties here at the 0.1, we have calculated the enthalpy at the 0.4 and we have calculated the enthalpy at the 0.5. Now, we have to calculate H3, H2 and H6. Now, for expansion the LP turbine, so the 3 to 4 is the expansion the LP turbine, S3 equal to S4. So, S3 equal to S4, which is 7.604. So, here it is very clear 7.604, here it is again 7.604. But here we do not know the pressure, but we know the temperature. So, from the entropy of superheated steam table, there is one table for entropy of superheated steam, entropy of superheated steam table, S3 equal to 7.604 and T3 equal to 500 degree Celsius. So, this is the condition known parameter, S3 equal to 7.604 and T3 equal to 500 degree Celsius. We refer and find out P3 equal to 14 bar. So, instead of 7.604, we have 7.603 in the superheated steam table. So, that is all right. So, 7.604 equal to 7.603. So, the P3 equal to 14 bar. So, the pressure here, it is 14 bar. So, P3 equal to P2 equal to 14 bar. Now, the enthalpy here, 14 bar and T3 equal to 500 degree Celsius, enthalpy of superheated steam, H3 equal to 3473.9 kilojoules per kilogram and from the steam table here P3 equal to P2, so at the 14 bar HF2 equal to 830.1 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 1957.7 kilojoules per kilogram, SF2 equal to 2.284 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SFG2 equal to 4.181 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, these are all the values taken from the steam table. Now, for the expansion of the in the HP turbine, so S1 equal to S2. So, look at here S1 equal to S2. Now, we want to know the quality here at the 2. So, S1 equal to S2. So, S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, 6.146. So, S1 equal to, we have taken S1 equal to 6.146. So, 6.146 equal to 2.284 plus X2 into 4.181 is equal to, solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.99. So, the drainage fraction at the 0.2, actually refer to the diagram. So, it is in the superheated region, but actually this is here in the wet region. So, the X2 equal to 0.99. Now, you calculate the enthalpy of the steam, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 830.1 plus 0.99 into 1957.7, which is 2768.2 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, the specific enthalpy in the pump, WP equal to H6 minus H5, which is VFI into P6 minus P5, which is equal to 0.001005 into P6 equal to 200 bar and P5 equal to 0.05 bar into 100 to convert bar into kilopascal. So, this 100 is converting, is used for converting bar into kilopascal, and calculating the value, pump work equal to 20.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And from this equation, we calculate H6 equal to 20.1 plus H5. So, H5 equal to WP H5 equal to HF5, which is 137.8. So, this equal to H6 is equal to 157.9. So, H5 already we have mentioned here, H5 equal to HF5 equal to 137.8. Now, the turbine work, WT equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. Substituting the values, WT equal to 3241.1 minus 2768.2 plus 3473.9 minus 2319.22 equal to 1807.58 kilojoules per kilogram. And pump work already we calculated, pump work equal to H6 minus H5 equal to 20.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And net to work per kg of the steam, W net equal to WT minus WP, which is 1807.58 minus 20.1 equal to 1787.48 kilojoules per kilogram. And the heat supplied, QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2, which is equal to 3241.1 minus 157.9 plus 3473.9 minus H2 equal to 2768.2 equal to 2378.9 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the efficiency, eta equal to WT plus WP divided by heat supplied, which is 1807.58 minus 20.1 divided by 3788.9 equal to 0.471, which is 47.1%. So, the answer to the problem, the net work done per kg of the steam equal to 1787.48 kilojoules per kilogram, and thermal efficiency equal to 47.1%. We take one more example on the reheat cycle here. So, this is from the unionized question paper November 2018. In a reheat Rankine cycle, the steam enters the steam turbine at 30 bar and 400 degrees Celsius and expands in the high pressure steam turbine to an intermediate pressure of 3 bar, at which it is reheated to 400 degrees Celsius before entering the low pressure turbine. The condenser pressure is 0.5 bar. The mass flow rate of the steam is 40 kilograms per second. Calculate the specific steam consumption, net to work per kg, power output and thermal efficiency of the turbine. So, this is the representative diagram, the temperature entropy diagram for the reheat cycle, and we write down the given data. So, P1 equal to P6 equal to 30 bar, P2 equal to P3 equal to 3 bar, P4 equal to P5 equal to 0.5 bar, temperature T1 equal to T3 equal to 400 degrees Celsius and mass flow rate is 40 kilograms per second. So, it is a straightforward problem. All the data are given. So, just refer to the steam table, take the properties and then we have to calculate. First, we take the initial state. So, here 0.1, 30 bar and 400 degrees Celsius, superheated steam. So, we have to refer to the enthalpy of the superheated steam. H1 equal to 3232.5 kilojoules per kilogram Then there is another table, entropy of superheated steam, referred to the table for pressure equal to 30 bar and temperature equal to 400 degrees Celsius, S1 equal to 6.925 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from steam table, P3, so here P3 equal to 3 bar, TS to saturation temperature is 133.5 degrees Celsius, HF2 equal to 561.5 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2163.2 kilojoules per kilogram, HF2 equal to 1.672 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 5.319 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So everything from this steam table straight away, note down carefully, that is very important. So carefully note down the parameter. Then for isentropic expansion, the HP turbine, so S1 equal to S2, so S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2, so substituting 6.925 equal to 1.672 plus X2 into 5.319, solving the equation X2 equal to 0.987, then we calculate the enthalpy H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 561.5 plus 0.987 plus 2163.2, this is equal to 2696.58 kilojoules per kilogram. And for the third condition, P3 equal to 3 bar and T3 equal to 400 degrees Celsius, again we refer the superheated steam table. Enthalpy of the superheated steam is 3725.2 kilojoules per kilogram, and the entropy of the superheated steam equal to 8.034 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Then for the final condition, P4, so here we have the P4 equal to 0.5 bar, so from the steam table, P4 equal to 0.5 bar, HF4 equal to 340.6 kilojoules per kilogram, HG4 equal to 2646 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, kilojoules per kilogram, VF4 equal to 0.00103 meter cube per kilogram, SG4 equal to 7.595 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, saturation temperature TS4 equal to 81.35 degrees Celsius, which is 354.35 Kelvin. Now for isentropic expansion in the LP turbine, again S3 equal to S4, we take S3 equal to SG4, we take S3 equal to S4, so S3 equal to, right hand side, S4 equal to SG4 plus Cp into logarithmic of T4 by TS4. So we assume at the outlet of the isentropic expansion, at the outlet of the LP turbine, it is superheated vapor. So for superheated vapor, the entropy is SG4 plus Cp into logarithmic of T4 divided by TS4. So, 8.034 equal to 7.595 plus 2.2 logarithmic of T4 divided by 354.35, and solving this equation, T4 equal to 432.6, which is equal to 159.6 degree Celsius. So, this is the temperature of the superheated steam. Now, the enthalpy of the superheated steam, H4 equal to HG4 plus Cp into T4 minus TS4, which is 2646 plus 2.2 into 159.6 minus 81.35 equal to 2818.15 kilojoules per kilogram. And the H5 equal to HF4, which is 340.6 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the pump work, specific enthalpy in the pump, H6 minus H5 equal to VFI into P6 minus P5, which is 0.00103 into 30 minus 0.5 equal into 100 equal to 3.04 kilojoules per kilogram. So the pump work is 3.04 kilojoules per kilogram, and the H6 equal to 3.04 plus 340.6 equal to 343.64 kilojoules per kilogram. So we calculated all the enthalpy H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. Now we calculate the turbine work, WT equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4, which is WT equal to 3232.5 minus 2696.58 plus 3725.2 minus 2818.15 equal to 1442.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work equal to H6 minus H5 equal to 3.04 kilojoules per kilogram. Net work done equal to WT minus WP equal to 1442.97 minus 3.04 equal to 1439.93 kilojoules per kilogram. And power output is M into W net, work, net to work output in the mass flow rate equal to the power output. So, 40 into 1439.93 equal to 57,597.2 kilowatts. That is the power output of the turbine. and heat supplied equal to QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. Substitute the numerical values 3232.5 minus 343.64 plus 3725.2 minus 2696.58 equal to 3917.48 kilojoules per kilogram, and thermal efficiency equal to WT minus ETA equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied, which is equal to 1442.97 minus 3.04 divided by 3917, that is 3917.48 equal to 0.3675, which is equal to 36.75%. The specific steam consumption or the steam rate, SR equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP equal to 3600 over 1442.97 minus 3.04 equal to 2.5 kilogram per kilowatt hour. And the answer to the problem, net to work per kg of the steam 1439.93 kilojoules per kilogram, net to power output equal to 57,597.2 kilowatts, specific steam consumption is 2.5 kilograms per kilowatt hour, and thermal efficiency of the cycle is 36.75%. And we stop here. So these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to your queries. Thank you for watching, and we will meet again.